In the metal quadrant today, taking a look at the March copper contract, which had a pretty significant gap lower today. The session started with a 1.29% gap lower from yesterday's closing price, then rallied up, but didn't quite get up to yesterday's settlement. The high today, 4.4910, was down a half of 1%, a little bit more than that, actually, 53 basis points. And the low was down 2.33%. at 4.4100. Last week's 2.3% gain, 2.34% gain in copper has been completely erased by the moves over the last 4 days. And it's been pretty mixed. They've been two up, two down. But overall, the down moves have been much, much stronger. Now, the Fed decision yesterday put a little bit of pressure on commodities in general. You even saw crude oil go up to a new 2022 high, all the way back to the highest level of 2014, but then fall as the Fed decision starts to make its way through the market that the Fed is going to try to slow demand with higher rates and slow inflation. And inflation, well, commodities are a big part of that. Commodity inflation has been very strong and has been part of the overall driving factor as seen through the higher PPI figures with commodity prices. So if the Fed is actually going to be effective in driving down inflation, it could push commodity prices lower and potentially, at least initially, push some speculation out of the price of copper. But also the Chinese economy, we had a pretty important figure last night out of China, industrial production, and they missed expectations. So a slowing of the Chinese economy also putting a little bit of pressure on copper. And then, of course, the stronger dollar driven by that Fed decision as well. All of this pushed copper down to about 2% lower on the day.